Hi, so in this video I'm going to convert my old keyboard and NES controller circuits into proper cards for my 6502 backplane. I'll also develop some test programs in 6502 assembly to show the output on my TMS9918 display. So first up I'll open EasyEDA and make a start on this circuit. So I'll be making a few minor changes to the circuits I had on breadboards. The most significant one will be adding two NES controllers instead of one. In all of my cards, I've been using 74688 comparators to do the address decoding. And for this card, I'll pair it with a 74138, which will give me the four different devices I need for the keyboard and NES controllers. The 74688 is used to decode addresses down to a card level, and the 74138 demultiplexer will be used to select either the keyboard status register or data register. And for the NES side, it'll select either NES port A or NES port B. So the brains behind the keyboard controller are a PIC microcontroller, and I have another video which covered the development of that, which I'll link in the description. So the PIC microcontroller has two different modes. One is to read data from the circular buffer, and another is to get the status, which is primarily whether the circular buffer contains data which is ready to be read or not. The PIC microcontroller is now running with an external crystal, so I can run it at 20 megahertz. That allows the PIC to get around 5 million instructions per second, which is plenty enough to service both the CPU requests and the keyboard sending scan codes. The PIC also includes an interrupt signal which can be used to tell the CPU when there's a scan code available. I've added bus transceivers for both the data and the status because the PIC can't respond fast enough to enable or disable its output lines for that. So I'm using a NAND gate here to create a set reset latch. When the status register is queried, that resets the signal, and when the data register is queried, it sets it. Based on this, the PIC knows when it can update to the next scan code in the circular buffer. So I'll just add in some decoupling caps for each of the ICs. And for the most part, that's the keyboard side done. So now I'll switch back to the NES side of things, and this one's fairly simple. Basically there's a 74595 serial to parallel shift register which grabs the data from the NES controller, and when the 74138 enables that port, it just outputs to the bus. So the last item for the NES controller is the 74161 counter. This is used to generate the clock and latch signals for the NES controllers. I've found that the NES can't handle the clock rate that I'm running the machine at. So the counter chip halves the clock rate and also generates the latch signal on its carry output, which is every 8 pulses. So that's about it for both of those sub-circuits now, and I'll just tidy up the schematic and we'll start building it. So that was a bit of an anti-climax. I forgot to update my software. The ports have changed and the NES button order has been reversed. So I'll just go and update that in my code now, and I'll burn a new ROM and we'll see how that looks. So obviously I also have to add support for the second NES controller. My code only has the one at the moment. So I have many helper macros and subroutines to deal with all of these peripherals, but I don't have any for NES 2, so I'll just add that in as well. As you can see, I can also just click on the Acme errors and it'll take me straight to that line in the code, which is very convenient. So I also need to update my emulator to match as well. So I need to add the second NES controller there and also add support for the keyboard status register, which I didn't have when it was on breadboards. That's done, so I'll just try Invaders in the emulator. Looks good. Let's try out the real thing. Okay, that looks great. So let's try the keyboard. And that's not working in the emulator. I just need to fix my keyboard code. Okay, it was looking at the wrong bit in the status flag. Okay, let's try that in the emulator. Looks good. And we'll try that on the real machine. Great. We'll just enter a couple of basic programs. And I'll have to try out David Murray, the 8-bit guy's favorite maze program as well. Let's see how that goes. Amazing. Okay, so I've gone all out here and written some graphical test programs for this card. So first up is the NES controller tester. So here we can see testing port A, and I've only got one controller at the moment, so I need to unplug it and re-plug it to test out port B. So we'll just try that. And there we go, port B working as well. And so I've also written a keyboard tester, which is really testing out my TMS 9918 skills as well. So we can see we've got multiple key handling working, and it's very responsive. So yeah, pretty happy with that. So that's it for this video. And if you've made it this far, thanks for watching and please consider subscribing. I've got more content planned on this build and you should be able to try along at home on the emulator as well. Thanks.